today we'll be forgiving our parents and we'll be zapping. I like that. You like that title, Zap? What a title, huh? So you know you're going to do some fascinating analyzing with me today, with Mr. Byam and Mr. Walter. Those are marvelous titles. I want to tell Eric Ashley and Richard Ornstein that there are, in this world of ours, many, many leaders with many, many followers. But the man alongside me, I want you to know, has given great, great solace and guidance spiritually to maybe generations or decades of people all over the world. And even though Sri Chinmoy, it's kind of gauche or kind of superficial to ask you to condense hundreds of books or a lifetime of teachings into what they call a 30-second soundbite. But if I would ask you to explain part of your philosophy or a little bit of your window on the universe, how would you explain your world to somebody who might be watching Sri Chinmoy right now for the first time on any TV show?
Our philosophy is love, devotion, and surrender. We love mankind soulfully, and we devote our lives to mankind, and we surrender sleeplessly to the will of God.
Now I'm going to give Mr. Ashley and Mr. Ornstein a little bit of a surprise. I'm going to show you one of my highest rated moments ever on TV, when this man, through mind power, lifted up a few million pounds, namely me. I want to bring back one of my... Can I show a little bit of this? Would you enjoy watching this again?
Certainly. By God's grace, I have lifted 1,300 human beings.
At one time?
No. Different. It took me a year and 3 months. And I'm so happy and grateful that you are one of those.
You know, before I even show the film clip, you got the... I see the film.
This is...
Yeah.
So...
This
I cherish this.
That's my first time on TV. I haven't changed much, have I, since those days? By the way, I want to read, if I may, something not about me, but something that I'll be announcing at a major banquet with the governor, with the mayor, with the... And after I announce it, maybe Eric Ashley might want to read the inscription. But let me give you the preview on TV, what I'll be doing at a major banquet in about a month. Sri Chinmoy, when you first visited us on Christmas of 1988, I called you 20th century's first global man because I saw that your life was dedicated to serving the spirit of man and that you have sought to do this through creativity in music, art, literature, and work in the political spheres at the United Nations, the British Parliament, and the United States Congress, where you have promoted and presented an inner approach to peace, and with your thousands of students and followers who improve their lives based on your philosophy. For your 25 years of service to mankind today, I want to be the first to present you with a special award as the 20th century's first global man. We should follow in your footsteps and become globally minded people with a concern for each other and a concern for our world. Congratulations, Sri Chinmoy. You are a 20th century's first global man, and maybe Eric Ashley might read the inscription on the trophy.
Well, this says, Sri Chinmoy, 20th century's first global man. It says, to Sri Chinmoy, for his dedicated and untiring service to mankind for world peace, presented by Joe Franklin on The Joe Franklin Show, November 1989.
I just want to ask a couple of your friends earlier, how do you feel about this man? Just a few of them, Sri Chinmoy. No, but by way, thank you, Eric. By way of setting the scene for the little clip I want to show, how about a little bit of that, Sri? A little bit of the meditating music, just to sort of give us that calming feeling that we could use in these days of stress? My friend writes me a note. He writes, there are selfless, dedicated, devoted leaders like yourself, like Sri Chinmoy. But this lady says, I must ask you, how do you feel about some of the so-called religious leaders who build a cult of personalities sort of around themselves? You got any theory on some of the people who are not as sincere as you?
Oh, no. I can say that I am not authorized to say anything on cult. Only I can say what our philosophy is. Now, unfortunately, nowadays, each and every religious leader is accused of this. Now, only I see when my philosophy does not agree with your philosophy, then you blame me and you say that I follow a cult and so forth.
I can only tell you one thing about the speech. Yes, continue.
I'm saying each individual has to enjoy freedom.
Right.
And President Jefferson said the freedom of religion. Here, religion comes the way of living, how I live, how you live. I must give full freedom to you because God is expressing, or divinity is expressing in and through you in a very special way. I have no right to interfere. And similarly, you will also do the same. Because who you want freedom? In freedom is peace.
And I see a burgeoning re-emergence of freedom in the as Soviet dominance seems to crumble. I'm seeing more of religious freedom in the East Bloc nations, which is
everywhere. And now in Germany and also everywhere now, people are longing of freedom because this freedom movement is coming from within, and everybody has to appreciate.
In Hungary and Poland, I don't know exactly. I mean Czechoslovakia. I'm seeing.
Hungary recently.
This foretells something good.
Definitely, it is good.
Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, as promised, I've got to show you one of my favorite film clips of all time. You're going to love this. I want to do a little bit of trivia, okay, Mr. Weinstein?
Sure.
No trivia over the fact that this is one of my favorite moments of all time on TV, being lifted in the air by my spiritual leader. The only mistake on the plaque when they said thousands of followers, there were millions of followers of this man, and I happen to know that for a definite fact. And here's a little bit of Joe Franklin TV Memory Lane clip, and it goes like this. This was one of my
scene to be believed
highlight moments. Would you do the honors, Sri? How high up would you say I am, roughly?
It is
about
1 foot. I've lifted you up about 1 foot.
And I'm about 15 or 20 feet high? I don't know. At least, huh?
At least.
Have you met those who were... Oh, there I go.
See?
Wow. Boy.
Wow, incredible.
So why do people feel peace listening to your music? If we had to ask you, when you did that before, there was a certain calm. What's the reason? What does it do to the people, Sri?
I am a seeker and God lover. I pray and meditate and I offer my prayers and meditations to God and God's will.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have been asked by a few of Mr. Shinmoy's ardent followers to mention a most exciting event. Would you care to make it official for us? Would you give us the data on the event, Sri?
It's Tuesday, November 14th, 7:30 p.m., and admission free. Reservations, a must for your free tickets and SASC to Peace Concert, Philadelphia. A free offering by Sri Chinmoy.
There's an easy generic phone number, 215, for any information, 215, Peace, P-E-A-C-E, 95. Eric, not to put the words in your mouth, you feel warm alongside this man?
It's unbelievable that I'm pretty hyper most of the time, but just sitting next to you and when you were playing the flute, there's something in the waves of the air pressure going through the flute, the waves, it's a very calming effect.
Mr. Ornstein, your final word about the man?
I think Sri Chinmoy is one of the wonders of the world.
He really is.
Very, very good.
I want to get him on the radio one night and talk for 6 hours. How about that?
Definitely.
We thank this fantastic man. I'll be right back with some more fantastic people following these words. Let's watch closely. Stay with me.